Hi everyone and welcome to another video. In this one, I'll be replacing the hard disk of this late 2012 iMac with an SSD. First, we will check the performance before the replacement. After that, I will open up the iMac and replace the hard disk with a new SSD, followed by a reinstallation of the operating system, macOS Big Sur in this case. Once that's all done, I'll be repeating the same tests as we did initially to see how much performance we gained with this relatively cheap upgrade. The process to replace the hard disk with an SSD is more or less the same for all 21.5-inch iMacs up until the mid-2017 model. Unfortunately, it's not a very easy process as it involves removing the screen from the enclosure, which is fixed with a one-time use tape for which we will definitely need a replacement.
Let's have a look at what exactly we need for this job. Obviously the SSD itself, a set of adhesives for your model, in my case that would be for the iMac A1418, a sharp knife, a Torx T10 screwdriver, guitar picks, a spudger, tape to temporarily fix the screen, and a USB drive that contains the macOS installation, more about that one later. Let's start with having a look at the current situation. Let me boot up the iMac while keeping an eye on the time, just to see how fast or slow this goes. One minute, 23 seconds. Let's keep that number in mind so we can compare it with the same test after installing the SSD. As mentioned, as you can see, this is a late 2012 iMac which has a 1TB 2.5-inch hard disk. This is how it looks like in disk utility, and take note about the time it took to start it as well. Now to test the raw performance, we can use AGA system test. As you can see, we get around 45 megabytes per second write and 68 megabytes per second read speed. Nothing too spectacular. Very important before starting this process is to make sure you have bootable installation media for the version of macOS which you would like to install on the SSD. As I will use a new, empty SSD, the iMac won't be usable without that. I created a guide on how to create this kind of media in an earlier video. You can find a card here or a link in the description for it. We're good to go, so let's shut down the iMac. To remove the screen, I usually start on the top left with a sharp knife to create an opening for a plastic card or guitar pick. This whole process is always a bit tricky as you can easily damage or crack the screen. Work around the full edge of the screen and remove the adhesive which is holding it in place everywhere. There isn't really a fixed guide, it requires you to feel a bit where it is still fixed and where not. Once you start to feel that the screen is getting loose, it's a good idea to put something soft in front to prevent it from falling on a hard surface. As soon as you are sure that the tape is no longer holding the screen, you can carefully move it forward and disconnect the two cables. The top one can be removed just like that. The second one has a small locking mechanism which you need to open first. Once disconnected, we can continue to remove the screen. And it was a good idea that I had that pillow there, as I didn't expect it to let go suddenly from the bottom tape. Here we have the iMac in all its glory. Internally, we can see the following. The hard disk, which we will replace. The power supply board. The motherboard with the CPU over here. And two memory DIMMs, which you can see a bit on the side. Let's first clean up the old tape. Then we can remove the four screws that hold the hard disk in place. And remove it while disconnecting the power and SATA cable. As you can see, the hard disk had a rubber case around it. We need to remove it. And then put the SSD back in it. Now we can reinsert it while reconnecting both cables. Then put back the small plastic brackets. Left side has the two middle and equal sized screws. Right side has the largest screw on the bottom and the smallest screw on top. That's all it took to replace that hard disk. Time to put back the screen for the first time in order to test the SSD. Here is where the tape comes in handy. Just to make sure that the screen doesn't fall down accidentally, I'll fix it on the bottom and top. Let's put in the bootable USB drive and connect the keyboard. Then we can start the iMac while holding the Alt key. This is to go to the bootloader so we can start the installation from the USB drive. Our screen is still working, which is a good sign, so let's launch the installation. From the installer, we can start disk utility. All seems good here, the SSD is properly detected. It's still initialized. To prepare it for the Big Sur install, click Erase. Then close disk utility and start the actual installation. This takes some time, and once completed, you need to answer some basic questions. Since I used the patched installation of Big Sur, I need to boot once more from the USB drive and run the post-installation tasks from there. That's it. The installation should be complete now. Let's shut down now and repeat the test which we did in the beginning, where I booted the system and launched Safari. With the hard disk, this took 1 minute and 23 seconds. The SSD is already done and clocks in at 40 seconds, less than half, a nice improvement if you ask me. As we can see, the SSD is doing fine. This is how it looks like in Disk Utility. And do you remember how long it took before to start Disk Utility? To have some hard numbers, let me repeat the same task with AGA system test as well. ...451 and 510 for the SSD, compared to 45 MB per second and 68 for the hard disk, almost 10 times as fast. Now, the last task on the list is to get the screen fixed properly again. For that, as mentioned, you need a kit of stickers tailored for your model of iMac. I start by putting back the pillow, and then I can remove the temporary tape I put on the top and open up the screen. Don't forget to disconnect the cables again. And remove the tape on the bottom as well. Before we fix the screen, we still need to remove the leftovers of the original tape that stayed on the side of the screen itself. All the old tape is gone, so let's put the screen back. Here I have the sticker set laid out how it has to be fixed. It can be difficult to find what goes where. For the top stickers, there is a gap for the webcam. For the right one, there are some pieces which are a bit more broad, and the bottom ones have these ends. The easiest way to do this is by peeling off part of the sticker. Then to use a pen or a small screwdriver to position the sticker correctly and fix it. Once the first part is done, remove the rest of the protection film and fix it. Repeat this for all stickers and make sure they are holding on properly to the iMac. Time to put the screen back. I'm removing the protection film from the bottom stickers. Then position the screen correctly. And remove the bottom half of the stickers on the side. Then we can close the screen and put back the connectors for the last time. Before we remove the rest of the protection from the stickers, a quick test to see if all is working fine. Looking good. So we can remove the protection film from the rest of the stickers. And make sure it's holding the screen well everywhere by giving it some pressure along the sides. One negative point of this generation of iMacs is how fast the screen gets dirty. But besides the proper cleaning, our iMac is ready and has a new life with this SSD.
Thanks a lot for watching. I really hope you enjoyed the video, and if you did, please put a thumbs up. If you like this and similar content, don't hesitate to subscribe to my channel for more of the same. Thanks again, and I hope to see you back here soon.